CPUs, so many kinds. So you want to build a PC, but you are missing the major component, which is the CPU, the brain of the computer. Computer words are scary, and buying your first CPU can be an overwhelming experience. There are so many kinds, and you may not know which to pick. So if this sounds like you, do stick around. Welcome back to Remeltan, a channel where we provide you with amazing PC build ideas without breaking your bank. If you enjoy our content, make sure to smash the subscribe as well as the bell to not miss out on future content. Okay, so there are three factors which you can consider when buying your first CPU. They are number one, AMD or Intel. Number two, the type of motherboard. And number three, the price and features. Point one, AMD or Intel. That's the first thing you should ask yourself. Why? Because they are the two biggest players in the CPU market. As you can see from this bunch of CPUs, we are going to talk AMD today. If you want an Intel CPU buying guide, drop us a comment and we may consider building one. Which brings us to point number two, the type of motherboard. If you have not seen or remember from our motherboard buying guide, we focus on the AMD B550 motherboard range. If you have not watched that, I will include a link up below and you can check out that guide. Which brings us to the final point, CPU and specs. So right now, we're going to talk about the most difficult part of buying a CPU. So yeah, let's carry on with that.
Right, so now it's my turn. It's time for me to go through a bit in detail as to where all these CPUs stand. So to cap it off, we have a Ryzen 3000 series here, and we have the new kids on the block, the Ryzen 5000 series right over here. So on the left, first off, we have the AMD Ryzen 5 3600. This is 6 core, 12 threads. The clock speeds will be printed in the caption. This guy starts off in Singapore at about $300. Now next, we come to the AMD Ryzen 7 3800, 8 core, 16 threads. This guy clocks in at about SGD 550, 560, around there. So let's put it at 550. Then we come to the new kids on the blocks. The new kids on the block, overall, performance-wise, in terms of like IPC or instruction per clock, they have about 15% improvement over their predecessor here. So first off, we have the Ryzen 5 5600X. This guy is 6 core 12 threads, much like this fella here. This guy is about SGD $500. Next, we have the Ryzen 7 5800X. This guy is $700. Then finally, we come to the Ryzen 9 5900X. This guy is 12 core, 24 threads. This guy is about $900. He's the most expensive of the 5 CPUs sitting right over here. Which one should you pick? This is where things get very interesting, so hear me out. I'll give you a couple of scenarios. Let's say you are a gamer. You're primarily going to use this for gaming, home use, that kind of thing. Or perhaps you're on a budget. So that's where the Ryzen 5, these two fellas come in. That's $300. This is $500. Given the fact that this guy has a 15% overall performance improvement in its IPC compared to this fella, so your first reaction is going to be, hey, I'm not going to bother with this fella. I'm just going to go with this fella and be done with it. Ah, but hold it right there. If the price difference was $50, then yes, I would say just go for this fella and don't look back. But this is $300. This is $500. Now, you have to consider that 200 SGD is quite a fair bit of money. It can mean the difference between you, let's say, buying a RTX 2060 and let's say an RTX 2070 Super, for example. The money that you save by going with this fella instead of this fella could buy you a better graphic card. If you're a gamer, this will overall give you a better experience in terms of average FPS in your games itself. However, if your budget is such that you can go for one of the new Ampere cards, an RTX 3070, an RTX 3080, then by all means, if you're playing in that price range, please put out the extra $200, get this fella. Because you don't want to end up in a situation where you splashed all that money on the RTX 3070 and 3080 and it's being held back by this fella. So which of these two to pick? It kind of depends on how your budget is like, that kind of thing. General rule of thumb, RTX 2060, 2060 Super, just go for this fella. If you're playing with an RTX 3070 and above, go for this fella. Next, we come to this fella here. I'm not going to bring in this fella into the equation first. But what if you have $500 plus to play with CPU? So let's say you're comparing this guy and we compare this guy. Very odd pairing, but hear me out. Which of these two you should pick? 500, 550. The answer is this. It depends. Are you a gamer? Most of the time, what you do is you play games. Then you go for the 5600X. But if, let's say, you are a content creator, or you know your professional applications likes cores, likes threads, then the 3800 here becomes a viable alternative. Because even though, yes, this guy's IPC is 15% lower than this fella, he has two more cores, he has four more threads. In multi-threaded applications, this guy still wins this fella by about 10%. So this is how you pick between these two fellas if you got $500 to $550 to spare for your CPU. Next, we come to this, the 5800X. Now this is no contest. This guy is gonna win. They both have the same amount of cores, they both have the same amount of threads. This guy is gonna be 15% faster. There's no doubt about it. But the price difference is more than about $100, it's about $150 actually. Now, couple of things you have to take into consideration. There's not only that $150 difference. One more thing that you have to keep in mind. The 5800X for $700 comes with no cooler in the box. It's a very light box, you can hear. This guy you can see is huge. Cause why, he comes with an AMD Rave Prism stock cooler inside there. It's not the best cooler around, especially if you compare with a premium 240mm radiator, that kind of thing. But it gets the job done. This guy, you're not only splashing out $150 more for this guy, you also have to factor in into your budget a cooler for this fella. While you could go with, let's say, a simple air cooler like the Cryoric H7, which goes for about SGD $65. So you have to consider that $700 plus $65. This running cost actually becomes more like $760, $770. So factor that in, $550, $770. So you have to ask yourself, is that 15% improvement worth that extra $200+? If the answer is yes, go for this fella. If you're on a budget and you think that $200 is better well spent on other things, like, again, in the previous example, a better graphic card, a bigger SSD, that kind of thing, then you go for this fella. Then we come to this fella, the 5900X. Now, I've always liked to say that this fella is the easiest of this lot for me to sell and promote. Cause why? These two, the Ryzen 5 and the Ryzen 7 range, how you choose which one of these can be quite challenging and all that. But when you go to the Ryzen 9 range, it becomes easier. Cause the kind of user that will pick a Ryzen 9, whether it's the, like a 5900X sitting here or even the king of the hill, the 5950X, this is 12 core, 24 threads. Now, it is very rare that actually any home user will probably need this amount of core and this amount of threads. If you're gonna buy this guy for just mainly handling your AAA titles, in my opinion, it's kind of a bit of an overkill. But if you are a content creator, you know your applications, like let's say you're an architect, you use V-Ray. Now, an application like that, the more cores and the more threads you give it, like I always say, the merrier it is. So when you are going in this, it's more of a case of, you know you need that amount of cores. You need that amount of threads. Now it only becomes a question of price. If you need 12 cores, 24 threads, $900 does the job very well. But of course, this guy, inside there in the box, there's no cooler. So it's not only this $900 that you have to factor in. You also have to factor in that this guy also needs a cooler. And for this guy, even though the 5800X will survive fine on a $65 air cooler like the Cryoric H7, this guy will also work quite well on a $65 H7 as well. But due to this guy having a higher TDP, you may probably want to go for something a little bit higher end in terms of like a cooling solution. Like let's say a 140mm air cooler like Cryoric H5 or the R1 Universal. Or if you want to go the, like the king of the hill, Noctua D14 or D15. If you're going liquid cooler, a 240mm radiator for this fella, minimum. To sum this whole thing up, if you are a gamer, you're mainly aiming for home use, the Ryzen 5 range will do the job nicely for you. As to which of these two, depends which graphic card you're going for. If you're going for a lower end graphic card, RTX 2060, 2060 Super, go for this fella. 3070 and above, go for this fella. If you're gaming plus streaming, or if you're a content creator on the side, it's a toss up between the 3800X and the 5800X. Price difference CPU to CPU is about $150, but if you factor that you have to buy a cooler for this fella, the price difference becomes $200. This one depends on your budget itself. If you can spare the extra $200 plus, at least go for this fella. If you can't, go for this fella. You can't go wrong. If you need 12 cores and 24 threads, or in the case of the 5950X, you need 16 cores, 32 threads. You know what you want, you know what you need, go for this fella, and don't look back, don't think too much.
So with that, you can buy your first AMD CPU. I should say that this is more of an AMD CPU buying guide, but whatever.
I hope I wasn't too long-winded.
Yes. So because holiday season is upon us, we just crossed Black Friday. So I hope you guys will go on to build your first gaming PC by the end of 2020. Of course, not looking at stock availability.
Especially for these buggers here.
Yeah, and the GPUs, because we are definitely going to do the GPU buying guide next. So that will also be a big issue anyway.
Yes.
Okay, if you have any other questions, make sure to drop us a comment. Let us know if you want an Intel buying guide also. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't watched our first guide, the motherboard buying guide, do so. So make sure to come back to our channel because we're going to put out a lot more awesome content. So for Gordon and I, we say goodnight and goodbye.